you very much. I appreciate that. I think any journalist will tell you, when there's a sense of satisfaction in our work, obviously, but when there's change that happens because of the work that's done, in this case, we're talking about minors who are undocumented and who at times get caught up. In this case, it's a young lady who was forced into prostitution. She's a minor, 14-year-old. She's a victim. And yet now, because she got apprehended, she's facing deportation. So she's victim twice. So obviously, because of this story, changes happened. And now law enforcement will look a little bit closer when it comes to victims of sex crimes before a deportation happens just like that. So
where's that girl now?
I'm sorry?
Where's that girl now?
She's doing fine. She's obviously, her and her family are trying to get their lives back together and trying to leave it in the past. But she's still in America, and she's still trying to further her life and further her career and further her education first, obviously. So I'm so happy. I'm so happy about this Emmy.
Where are you going to put this? All of these from this evening?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I'm thinking the living room. I'm thinking that if my wife will allow it. So, which brings me to another good point. My wife's always been there next to me. And then, if I may say this real quick, there are a few people, en español lo digo, en el centro California y en el Valle Imperial, que siempre me han apoyado. Gloria, mi tía María Elena, Esther, Estela, familia que siempre me ha apoyado. Muchas gracias. I'm talking about family who's always supported me. You know, when the going got a little bit rough, they were there. I was saying, hey, you can do it, keep going. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much, and I love you guys so much.
Congratulations. Real proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you.